Hi, I'm Johannes and product owner at Pesla. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you read variables from an OPC UA server using our new OPC UA custom sensor. Using that, you can monitor data from any device like PLCs, SCADA systems, MES, or any other devices which of an OPC UA server. Have fun! Okay, let's start right away monitoring variables from an OPC UA server using PRTG. The first thing you need to do is configure the connection to the system. So in our case, we have here backup IPC, and as usual, you need to go to the settings and configure the connection using the credential section. Here is also one for OPC UA, and the first thing you need to configure is the port to the system. Usually it's 4840, in our case it's 4852 now. We already adapted it. Then you need to specify the server path. So if you're running multiple OPC UA servers on a single device, you can specify a certain sensor using the server path, which is the last part of the application URI in OPC UA. Next, you need to configure security mode. In our case, we are fine with none, but you can of course enable sign or sign on encrypt, and then specify a proper client certificate, the key and the password for it. Also, you can select a security policy to encrypt using basic 256 and basic 256. SHA-256. But as I said, for our case, it's not needed. And last, you need to specify authentication method. So usually you can either go with anonymous or with username password. So just provide the username and the password if your server requires that connection. In our case, everything is fine and we can continue. Next, we're gonna add the sensor as usual over the sensor dialog. Just search for OPC UA, and there you find already a bunch of sensors for it. We focus now on the OPC UA custom, which is there to monitor up to 5 numeric values from our server. So what do we need to specify first? As usual, the sensor name. In our case, it's just the IPC health, because we are monitoring metrics which are crucial to the health of our IPC. Next, we can specify a sensor message node ID, which is just a string you can select from the server to display as the sensor message. In our case, we want to see which operating system is running on our IPC. And I just copy over node ID in the format you are used to from OPC UA. So first specify the namespace and then the node ID. In our case, now it's a string representation. That's why we have the S here. Next, we're going to add the first channel. And in our case, you want to see the CPU load of the device. And special for the OPC UA services, you can either choose from an automatic naming or enter custom name. So we prefer automatic naming because then we only need to name this thing once in the OPC UA server. And what is happening here is PRTG reads automatically the display string of the node you specify. So as unit, we select the percentage and the node ID we have here, which is just the CPU load of our backup device. Next, we're going to add the CPU temperature, which is also just a node ID. And we also select automatic naming, so we do not need to do anything else. And the unit is degrees Celsius. Next we're gonna add is the fan RPM. So our IPC has some fans, and of course you want to know the RPMs, because if they're going too high, probably the filter is full. And unit is RPM. And the last thing we're gonna add is if the security wizard is enabled on our devices or our IPC device. And also we select automatic naming, no unit required in that case, as you will see in a second. So let's add the sensor and see what we get back. So as you can see, we got some values back. So first the sensor message, as you can see, Windows 10 is running on our IPC, so everything fine. And then we have here the channels, and as you can see, they don't look too nice, but that's something specific to the device, so we can just adapt it by removing here and also removing that. And then we have a proper channel with the CPU usages, which is in our case 1%. Also, we clean up the other channels like temperature, which is 23 degrees Celsius. And the last security with it. So what's special on the security wizard side is, because it's a Boolean value in our OPC UA server, PRTG automatically converts it to a lookup channel. So here we can see that the security wizard is enabled, which means the Boolean is true, and we show it as true in PRTG. Of course, you can always change it to your own preferences. We ship two lookups with PRTG. One is a negative and one is a positive lookup. So whenever a true is false or true is true or none an error, basically. So you can select whatever you need. Of course, you can always adapt the lookups to your requirements and don't use the provided ones. Also, as usual, you can specify thresholds. So in our case, for temperature, we would like to get a warning if we reach more than 80 degrees. And of course, more than 100 because it's quite hot there. So we get a proper alert. Okay. And finally, if you adapt all the stuff, you can deploy them automatically using auto discovery. But first, you need to create a proper device template by just going back to the device and select create device template. So what is happening here? We specify IPC template as our template name. And as you can see, we provide the IPC health sensor we just configured in the template. And the cool thing is now we adapted the names, we set the thresholds, we check the lookups, and these settings also are converted into the template. So you can now roll out this sensor to all your devices in your shop floor, for example. Instead of configuring it by hand for every device, we now roll out to 100 devices using one click, as usual, with the auto discovery. And that's basically everything you need to know to monitor your OPC UA servers or values from OPC UA servers using the OPC UA custom sensor. I hope you really found this tutorial helpful, and if so, please give us a like or consider subscribing to our YouTube channel. Also, leave us a comment for feedback or any other topics. And if there are any questions, always ask us at support@pesla.com. Thanks for watching.